Dear farmers, dear students, in the last class we were discussing on the case studies, especially for rice, in respect of crop management. One was on the management of nursery when it was sown with 1 day old. The other case study was receipt of rain more than 150 millimeter in 6 rainy days, especially at the stage of tillering stage of the rice crop, where I was saying that if you go for agro advisory adaptation, then crop production risk gets reduced. Now for today's discussion, we will see how the weather based crop protection on pest and disease management, how agro advisory helps us to minimize the risk due to pest and disease, especially in rice. Normally, based on the scientific literature, the yield loss due to pest and disease in rice goes up to 30%. Let us see through case study also. Now here the case study is AgroMed advisory for blast rice disease as well as Helminthosporium leaf disease. How it is being managed? Now we are able to say that prevention is always better than cure. Normally pest and disease are triggered by environment, and within the environment the weather is the important factor that influences the incidence of disease and pest population in rice. Now the weather situation is anticipating high relative humidity 40 to 90%, combined with minimum temperature lesser than 20 degrees centigrade. At what stage of the rice crop this weather situation occurs? That is the question, which is at maximum tillering as well as at panicle in season stage. The weather situation is high relative humidity from 40 to 90%, and minimum temperature is lower, lesser than 20 degree centigrade, it occurs at maximum tillering as well as panicle initiation stage. So the stages, tillering stage and the panicle initiation stages of the rice, or sensitivity of the rice crop stages to the prevalent weather situation. So they have estimated that based on the previous study, 30% loss would occur if prevention is not taken based on the observation made on the weather. So what would be the proposed agro advisory for this situation? So go for timely plant production measures, that is go for application of systemic fungicides. So this is the way we have to do it, but against this, at present what farmers they do is they go to the your input dealers, especially the people who sells the fertilizers and the pesticides. He gives something, recommends something for his profit, and farmers goes with the confidence that will give protection to their crop, but does not happen. So what our suggestion is, let the farmer, after seeing the weather situation, after seeing the crop stages, let them move to the extension specialist or some agricultural institution like KVK, contact the officials and get the prescription and do the prevention against the occurrence of the disease. This is earlier to the occurrence of the disease, the AgroMed advisory proposes to take preventive actions. Now let us move to another example. This is the example for ticca leaf spot in groundnut. It may be early leaf spot or it may be late leaf spot. What is the weather situation that triggers this disease in groundnut? Anticipating high evening relative humidity, this is not evenly, evening relative humidity more than 60% for a week continuously for 7 days, and high leaf wetness. This provide a congenial environment for the leaf, the disease spores to get germinated and comes to the level of damaging the crop. The situation of the crop is peak vegetative stage. At this stage, the groundnut leaves are very thicker, greener, and it stores more carbohydrates or starch or photosynthetic material. That is why with the triggering of the weather elements, this disease comes to the groundnut. Here, based on the sensitivity of this crop to this weather situation, they studied that the yield loss may go up to 40%. If the disease is not controlled after seeing the your weather forecast and the information at the peak vegetative stage, if the plant protection is not taken, there will be yield loss up to 40%. So the proposed agro advisory would be adopt timely plant protection measures. This is very important area to be understood. As I indicated for rice, people go for to the your local dealers and get some medicine and spray to their crop. That may not protect their crop. They can meet extension specialist or some KVK, meet the people, go with the sample, plant samples, show to them. They will suggest some effective chemicals that can be sprayed in advance after seeing the weather situation. Coming to the third one for rice, we say BPH, brown plant hopper, very worst insect. Normally this insect appears during dillering stage of the rice crop. When there is a cloudy environment, maybe due to cyclone or maybe due to some environmental pollution, cloudy environment would persist during the rice growing season, especially at the peak tillering stage. The brown plant hopper at that time will come and stay at the base of the rice crop. They multiply, enlarge, suck the sap of the rice crop and do the damage whatever they like. The result is the yield loss. So based on the sensitivity of the crop stage to this weather situation is cloud cover more than 6 hectare. In our earlier classes, we were seeing that the cloud cover is being measured in scale from 0 to 8 hectare. Now today it is 6 hectare. So at this situation, what will happen? The brown plant hopper gets multiplied, stay inside the plant, that is your within the plant bottom of the tiller, they suck the sap and it causes damage. The advisory is timely plant protection and also giving your drainage so that the water may not provide a congenial atmosphere to the insect which stays at the base of the bottom of the plant. So on the farmers, normally they never mind for this incident because it may not be ocularly seen from the upper side of the plant. It could be seen only in the bottom. Whenever you go inside the field, you can able to see the insect flying across. So you have to take enough plant protection measures for that, provide drainage, and also meet our agricultural specialist, extension specialist, or go to KVK with the sample, show to them, get prescription and control the insect in advance. So these are the few examples I like to focus on the case study of management of your insect and pest. Here the study was taken between two group of farmers. One is farmers who adapted, another one is farmers who did not adapt. The economics analysis will be discussed at my later classes. Thank you very much.